Hi viewers, welcome to my channel. This is Sennappa Sennappa Rajan. We are in continuation of Siemens logo PLC tutorial. Okay, so if you are new for my channels, please do subscribe and click the bell icon for future video upload notification. Okay, so let's start. Go to new function block diagram. Okay, here we go. Today I'm going to explain you about NAND gate and NOR gate. Okay, so we will see how this NAND gate and NOR gate is working and how we can utilize these blocks. Okay, so first we will check NAND gate. Okay, this NAND gate is nothing, it will work opposite to the AND gate. Okay, if you want simple explanation, this will work like, you know, parallel contact of NC blocks. Okay, first we will connect output. Okay, and we will connect inputs. Okay, now we'll test simulation. Now, as I told you, this will work like, you know, parallel NC contacts. Okay, now you have four inputs, but these four of inputs are not enabled, so this will give output. Now one is enabled, second is enabled, third is enabled, fourth is enabled. Now the output is disabled. Okay, so if you disable any input, this will give output. Okay, so this is a NAND gate. Okay, now we will see NOR gate. Okay, this NOR gate, this will work like, you know, just opposite of this NAND gate. Okay, this we will see how this will work. Okay, so as I told you, this NAND gate will work parallel NO contact. Okay, bunch of parallel NO contacts. This NOR gate will work serious NO contacts. Okay, that I will explain you how this will work. Okay, now we will check simulation. Now see, in normal, if there is no any input, this will give output. If you give any one input, this will disable the output. That means if any input enable, this will disable the output. So this is the function of NOR gate. We will see now truth table for NAND gate. Okay, now as I told you, this will work like, you know, this is NAND gate, this will work like parallel series contacts. Okay, see, 1 2 3 4, there are four inputs. If no inputs is available, this will give output. If any one input is available also, this will give output. When all the inputs are available, all the inputs are enabled, then this will disable the outputs. Okay, so this is the truth table for NAND gate. You will see the NOR gate truth table. Okay, see, this is just opposite of this NAND gate. Okay, if no inputs is available, this will enable the output. If any input available, this will disable the outputs. Okay, this is the truth table. But in one more way, I will explain you in a simple method. Okay, okay, as I told you, this is NAND gate. Okay, this is NAND gate working. This is bunch of NC contacts, okay? This is bunch of NC contacts connected in parallelly, okay? From here, if any input, if you disable any input, still this will give the output, okay? If this one is enabled, this will open, still this will give inputs. If four of these inputs enable, that means this will open, then only the output will cut off, okay? This is the NAND gate working logic. But NOR gate, as I told you, bunch of NO contacts, bunch of NC contacts connected in series, okay? Now if you enable any inputs, now example, if you give input 1, this will open, so output will cut. If you give input 3, also this will open, the series contact will cut, the output will be disabled. This was here I shown you, okay? This is bunch of NC contact connected in parallel, okay? If you give input also, if you give any inputs, this will still enable the output. If you give 4 input, that means it will disable. Got it? But in XOR gate, NOR gate, if you give any input, this will disable the output like this, okay? Okay, so this is how NAND gate and NOR gate is working, and you can utilize in your programming logic as per your requirement, okay? So I hope you understand this gates working logic. I will meet you in next video with different blocks, okay? Till then, bye from Sennappa Rajan.